In an example Meraki network, Meraki's MG devices exist here, offering wireless WAN connectivity over nothing more than a 4G LTE connection. This means with a SIM card and MG device, you can give primary WAN connectivity for temporary or flexible deployment options. Jumping into the dashboard, we can see here what this looks like. In the most basic view, we can see the two Ethernet handoff ports from this MG device. Moving then into the settings, we can look at having multiple SIMs with some models, and then into settings with the radios. Following on from that, we can also look into the live traffic data and even historical data around latency and packet loss. In addition to flexible use cases where the MG device offers primary WAN connectivity, it can also be used in a range of secondary WAN connectivity roles. This is to help provide things like high availability, link redundancy, decoupling functionality, and also giving insights into your WAN performance if you're in a wireless location. The cellular gateway view is a prime example of this, allowing you to see if there's been connectivity issues at a glance. Once identified, we can then quickly navigate through the settings menus to troubleshoot and fix any issues. Here, I've quickly identified if there's any DHCP issues. I've then looked at the physical location of the device, and then I'm going through and troubleshooting pinging the device as a quick check to try and find out what the root cause of these issues is. From here, I'm going to navigate to my configuration settings to give one final look at the settings on the device to see if there's any possible root cause. Now we've looked at some of the functionality of MG devices, let's jump into actual models. There are currently four MG models, the key differences being those with an E having an external antenna and the difference in download speeds. Once you've settled on MG hardware, it's then necessary to pick a license. These are not model specific, they are not type specific, but they are term specific. A list of all the possible combinations is given here. Finally, it's necessary to pick any relevant accessories. These include power adapters or PoE injectors if PoE is not going to be used from a switch, and a directional patch antenna for the MG21E if required. In summary, you need hardware, you need a license, you need accessories, and a SIM card with data plan from your preferred carrier.